हेलो एवरीवन, दिस इज़ पूजा शर्मा एंड वेलकम बैक टू वाइश आई एस यूट्यूब चैनल। सो टुडे वी आर स्टार्टिंग अ वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग सीरीज़ विच विल कम अंडर द मिनी सीरीज़ एंड दिस इज़ बीइंग डन स्पेसिफिकली फॉर योर प्रिलिम्स रिविजन। एंड मेक श्योर दैट यू सब्सक्राइब एंड गिव अस अ फीडबैक एंड लाइक द वीडियो सो दैट वी मेक मोर एपिसोड्स लाइक दिस विच विल हेल्प यू फॉर योर प्रिलिम्स प्रिपरेशन। So this is about the biosphere reserves of India. So every year there is a question which comes from this topic in the form of a national park, a wildlife sanctuary, a protected area, or sometimes even a direct question on biosphere reserves. So before we begin with the video, this is the contact details of Vaish IAS. You can contact on this number on WhatsApp for your enrollment details for UPSC test series. You can even email us and visit our YouTube channel and you'll find many mini series going on which will help you for your prelims preparation. So next we have the Nanda Devi National Park. So this Nanda Devi National Park or the Nanda Devi Biosphere Reserve, it was established in 1982. It is a national park which is situated around the peak of Nanda Devi in the Chamoli Garhwal district of Uttarakhand. So we all know that Uttarakhand is over here in the north, just below Jammu and Kashmir, and this park, it entirely lies in the elevation which is more than 3500 meters above the mean sea level. So this national park, it was inscribed a World Heritage Site by the UNESCO in 1988 and it was later expanded and renamed as Nanda Devi and Valley of Flowers National Parks because the flowers which are found in these regions, they present a very scenic beauty. So within the national park lies the Nanda Devi Sanctuary and a glacial basin. It is surrounded by a ring of peaks between 6000 meters and 7500 meters high, and also it is drained by the river Rishi Ganga through the Rishi Ganga gorge and a steep and almost impassable defile. So there is this a region which is not possible to pass through or travel through. It makes traveling very difficult. So the national park, it is embedded in the Nanda Devi Biosphere Reserve. That means it is inside the Nanda Devi Biosphere Reserve. Then again, this is in turn encompassed in the buffer zone, which is around the Nanda Devi and Valley of Flowers National Parks, the UNESCO sites. So the best time to visit Nanda Devi Park is from May to October. So the first recorded attempt to explore this sanctuary was in 1888 by W.W. Graham, who could proceed only up to Rishi Ganga. And other attempts by explorers in 1870 like T.G. Longstaff, 1926, 1927, 1932, which is by Hogg Rutledge, did not fetch fruitful results because it was very difficult to pass through that defile. And Eric Shipton and H.W. Tillman, they entered the inner sanctuary through Rishi Ganga in 1934, thus opening the extensive exploration into the sanctuary. And in 1939, the area was declared as a game sanctuary. So, for this is a current affair related news which recently took place. So, what happened was on 7th February 2021, which is this year, from around 10:45 a.m. in the morning, a flooding disaster occurred all along the Rishi Ganga River and its valley following a very disastrous landslide, avalanche. Avalanche is nothing but when the snow breaks and, comes trembling down, or a glacial lake outburst flood of the Nanda Devi Glacier. So the Nanda Devi Sanctuary within the national park, it can be divided into two parts, which is the inner and outer regions. So together they are surrounded by the main sanctuary wall, which forms a roughly square outline with high continuous ridges on the north, east and south sides. So on the west side, they are less high, but they still have imposing ridges which drop from north and south towards the Rishi Ganga gorge and which drains the sanctuary towards the west. So the inner sanctuary, it occupies roughly the eastern two-thirds of the total area and contains Nanda Devi itself. And the two major glaciers which are flanking the peak, the Uttari Rishi Glacier and the Dakshini Rishi Glacier, as you can see in the picture, we have Dakshini Rishi Glacier over here and Uttari Glacier over here. So these are fed by the small Uttari Nanda Devi and Dakshini Nanda Devi glaciers. So this region, it was already inhabited by the Aryanic, Mongolian and the Himalayan indigenous people as per the Vedas and the natural histories. But the first recorded entry of the British into the inner sanctuary was by Eric Shipton and H.W. Tillman in 1934 via the Rishiganga Gorge. So the outer sanctuary, it occupies the western third of the total sanctuary, and it is separated from the inner sanctuary by high ridges through which flows the Rishiganga, and it is split in two by the Rishiganga. So on the northern side lies the Ramani Glacier, following down from the slopes of Dunagiri and Changa Bank, and on the south it lies the Trishul Glacier, following from the peak of the same name. So there is a glacier which is named Trishul, and also there is a mountain range which is known as Trishul. So this portion of the sanctuary is accessible to the outside, but it requires a person to cross 4000 meters of height. So the first serious climbing expedition to the pass through the outer sanctuary was that of T.G. Longstaff, who climbed Trishul in 1907 via glacier. So the fauna which is found over here is the Himalayan musk deer over here. Then we have the mainland siro. Then we have Himalayan thar, which is over here. And then goral. This is goral. So goral are not found inside the park, but they are found around or in vicinity of the park. So the carnivores which are represented over here are the snow leopard, then we have the Himalayan black bear and the brown bear as well, and we can find langurs, and then the rhesus macaque, and also they are known to occur in the neighboring areas of the park. So in a scientific expedition in 1993, a total of 114 bird species was recognized. So the Nanda Devi National Park, it is a home to a variety of flora, that is flowers. So some of the 312 flora species that include 17 rare species have been found over here. So fir, birch and rhododendron. So this is fir. This is birch, and then we have rhododendron, and this is juniper, which are the main flora. And the vegetation, it is scarce in the inner sanctuary due to the dryness of conditions. And one will not find vegetation near the Nanda Devi Glacier because it's mostly covered with snow. So we can find Ramani, Alpine, Moses and Lichens, which are other notable floral species which are found in the Nanda Devi National Park. So apart from Nanda Devi, the following peaks which lie on the sanctuary is Devistan, Nanda Devi, Rishikot, and then on the sanctuary wall we have Hanuman, Dunagiri, Changa Bagh, Kalanka, Rishi Pahar, Mangraon, Dio Dhamla, Bamchu, we have Sakram, Latu Dura, Sunanda Devi, Nanda Ghat, then Panwali Doar, Mike Toli, Dev Toli, Mriktuni, Trishul and Bartha Toli, Himal. So these are all the ranges. You can pause the video and you can take a look at it. So on the outside wall, we can find Hardeol, Trishuli, Nanda Knot and Nanda Gunti. So again, you can pause the video or take a screenshot and keep it for your revision. So to conclude, what had happened was, in the Cold War era, when Chinese carried out their first nuclear test in 1964 and followed it up with a missile testing, the US and India, they planned to work in collaboration to spy on China's nuclear capabilities. So what they did is, they installed a nuclear powered spying device on Nanda Devi, and what had happened was, earlier there were no spy satellites in that time. And much of the clandestine intelligence gathering relied on the ground-based sensors. So any signals which were emitted on the ground, they could be tracked. But what happened is, the Chinese missile testing facilities, it was in the north of the Himalayan range, which was a very big hurdle in picking up these missile telemetry signals. Why? Because they were high up in the mountain range, and these ground-based sensors could not sense what signals were passed in the upper regions. So the CIA, they were looking for a high Himalayan peak which was secure enough, which could give a direct line of sight to the Chinese missile testing zone. And together with the Intelligence Bureau of India, they planned a secret mission to install a nuclear-powered listening device on top of the peak of Nanda Devi. So a joint team of the CIA, they hired US mountaineers together with the Indian contingent from the Defense Forces, and they were detailed to carry out a secret mission. So by the time the mountaineering season was over, the mission met with adverse climatic conditions, and they left behind the plutonium fuel device with the intention of renewing their attempt during the next year's climbing season. So remember these three words, I'll tell you why. So the follow-up Indian expedition during the next season, they found the device missing from where it was placed. And probably this device, it fell down due to the rock fall and slid towards the glaciers carrying the plutonium with it. So this plutonium filled fuel device, it fell down, it got slid downwards, which was carrying plutonium in it. So when all the follow-up secret expeditions launched to retrieve the device, it met with failure. And in 2018, it was reported that the tourism minister of Uttarakhand state, Mr. Satpal Maharaj, he met with the Prime Minister of India to express his apprehensions that the atomic device, which is this plutonium fueled device, so that had gone missing over 50 years, that had gone missing 50 years ago, it might be polluting the waters of Ganga because of the plutonium which was filled in it. But not only that, there are many other reasons also. The people itself who live in and around the Ganga River have been polluting it, all the waste and all the dead bodies and all of that. So this is all for today. I'll be back with more biosphere reserves. There are total 18 biosphere reserves. So we'll cover them as soon as possible so that you can read it and, you know, revise it once before prelims. So as I said earlier, that if you want us to, you know, make more detailed videos of all the national parks, the wildlife sanctuaries, we can do that, but for that we will need your help. So make sure that you give us feedback and comment in the comment section below that you want more detailed videos on all the national parks, wildlife sanctuaries which are present in the country, and we will also make videos on the Ramsar sites. So all these will be very important from prelims perspective. So all you have to do is just like, share, comment and subscribe our channel, and then that will motivate us to make us more videos so that it can help you in your prelims preparation. So this is your WhatsApp details, the number which is given on the screen. So you can contact on this number for your enrollment details for your UPSC test series, and also you can visit our YouTube channel and find more videos which will help you for your preparation. And you can also email us. So I'll be back with the next video. If the biosphere reserve is a little lengthy, I'll just make one video, and if it is small, then I'll try including one or two biosphere together in one video. So there are totally 18 biosphere reserves, so we'll try finishing it within 10 days or less than 10 days. Let's see. It depends. So I'll be back soon with the next biosphere reserve. Till then, all the best and thank you.